Imaginary numbers have always been believed to be simply that, imaginary. I remember when I was in year two, I just got back home from school, I had just learned my four times tables, I thought I was the smartest girl in the world, until my dad asked me, okay, what's 2 minus 3? At that age, I had no clue about negative number territory, so naturally I was confused. And I said, that's impossible. You can't do that. He then asked me, okay, what's 5 divided by 2? Again, I wasn't especially well-versed in the realm of fractions and decimals, so again I replied, that's impossible and doesn't exist. Of course, now at 16, I understand negatives and fractions, but we all once thought that they didn't exist. Similarly, imaginary numbers, numbers that have stumped mathematicians and been considered impossible for over 2,000 years, have only just been proven to exist. And their existence is still hardly acknowledged. I'm going to prove to you that imaginary numbers very well do exist, just in an alternate dimension, a dimension which lies beyond the real number dimension, which humans can't even see nor fully comprehend. Imaginary numbers are based on the square root of negative numbers, which may seem virtually impossible. After all, they don't have a solution within the realm of real numbers. As such, we've all been told that imaginary numbers simply don't exist, and the main reason for that is because they've been given a terrible, misrepresentative name, which suggests that these numbers don't exist at all. In fact, a famous 19th century mathematician called Gauss exclaimed that the mysterious obscurity surrounding these numbers is attributed to the ill-adapted notation, and instead opted to rename positive, negative, and imaginary numbers as direct, inverse, and lateral units, respectively. So from now on, for the sake of Gauss, I will be referring to them as lateral numbers. To prove that lateral numbers are real numbers, we can prove that they follow the conventions of other numbers we already know about. They should follow the basic laws of algebra and arithmetic. And as it turns out, they do, for the most part. They at least follow the laws of addition and multiplication. But we can also prove that lateral numbers are real numbers geometrically. While real numbers live on a one-dimensional number line, lateral numbers inhabit a perpendicular axis, creating a two-dimensional plane called the complex plane. Positional changes on the complex plane follow the same logic as those on a real number line, showing that lateral numbers aren't just some random extra number or hack, but that they do exist, just in a dimension orthogonal to the real number line. Now, you may be wondering, if lateral numbers exist in a dimension that we can't even see into, then what's actually the point of their existence? The short answer is, you don't really need to see it to use it. For example, most of modern physics consists of searching for objects or phenomena that are virtually invisible, like the tiny quarks of quantum physics. To put it into perspective, quantum physics consists of studying the behavior of particles that are either very, very small, like the electrons in your electrical wires, or objects that are millions of times colder than the insides of your fridge. And it is chock full of complex and lateral numbers. As it turns out, lateral numbers are a near necessity in modern physics. So, despite their weirdness and obscurity, the oddness of lateral numbers was very quickly disregarded in favor of their usefulness. For instance, lateral numbers are used to model some oscillations, such as those found in grandfather clocks, or in many equations pertaining to waves, be they vibrations of a plucked guitar string, or undulations of water along a coast. Imaginary numbers are incomprehensible to the human eye. Yet, they are becoming increasingly relevant in the modern day. This isn't just a question of whether imaginary numbers are real or not. It also begs the question to all of you, what other dimensions are there that we have yet to discover? And will the basic foundations of mathematics continue to hold as we learn about them? Thank you.